Hello everyone, welcome back to the City of Poncho Build Part 3. I hope you're all having a great holiday season. Thanks for tuning in. So today we're going to be working on building a shopping center and a higher traffic capacity interchange. We're also going to be unlocking our second tile. And putting in a lot of detailing. I'm glad y'all are here. I hope you enjoy this video. I have to apologize for the voice audio in this video. I wound up recording all this game footage and it didn't pick up any of my voice audio. So this video, I'm just going to be kind of narrating it and explaining what I'm doing as I'm doing it. I'm also gonna speed up a lot of it so we can cover a lot more of the build and details while not going through step by step in real time. So thanks again for tuning in. Drop a like, subscribe, hit that bell button, and let's get started on this thing. So we're going to start by unlocking our first tile, working back towards the interstate. That's going to be the direction that we're going to work our city in. So there's some things that happen off camera, like I'm going to wind up deleting our four windmills that we started with, and I moved them over to a new wind farm up on the hill. So I'm going to build kind of on this upper section and use these trees as sort of a guideline of where I'm going to have that main road. So this is the start of our interchange. We're going to lift the dirt up and level it out and make sort of a natural bridge instead of raising the road off the ground. It seems like you can have a lower profile bridge this way instead of using the tabs to lift it. So I start off by making a node in the middle for a road guideline, and then I'm just going to span it across this gap here, and I think that came out really nice. It's good low profile. The fact that I put it on two berms is money that we saved instead of building this long drawn out bridge. So the next thing we're going to do is work on our queuing lanes. So I'm going to have to downgrade these highway roads to the regular two-lane road. It gives me the grid to work with, and it's also easier to connect it up at the end. And then you can upgrade it back to the main highway road. What kind of freaked me out at first was when I originally downgraded that, I didn't have the milestone unlocked yet. That would allow me to upgrade them to the highway roads again, so I kind of panicked a bit at first there, but then I realized it was the next milestone, so it was, by the time I had finished up this build, I knew I could upgrade them back to the regular highway roads. So this is a pretty basic style trumpet interchange here that I'm doing on both sides. It's a really basic interchange. There's a lot of tutorials and stuff for them on YouTube. It's not hard to explain how to do it. You can also just pause through my video and see the measurements I used. So you can see right here, I was having trouble bringing that into the three-lane highway, and that's why I downgrade it, because then I can connect it in and upgrade it back up to the three-lane highway. Not a problem. I'll just have to make sure it's facing the right direction. This is two-lane roads feeding into a two-lane road going back up to the arterial road there. So this is going to come up into two roundabouts on either side, where those two queues for the highway are going to feed up into these roundabouts. And I'm also going to feed the frontage road on the residential side up into this roundabout on the left as well. And I'm just leveling all this out just to make it look a lot nicer and smoother. Getting used to the earth working tools was definitely one of the more challenging things on the PlayStation with joysticks and stuff, but after some time and practice, it's come a lot easier. So when doing these kind of curves like this, I like using the curve road tool over the freeform because it gives me the road length measurements when I'm doing the curves, and the freeform tool doesn't do that. So I record all these videos as I'm just kind of coming up with these ideas on the spot. So right here, I'm just trying to figure out a way to measure for my roundabouts, and I think I found it was 5 units away from the center, and then a 5-unit all the way around like that. That made a pretty decent size for all this. When I plan these videos, like my builds and stuff, I definitely spend a lot of time searching like Google Maps and Google Earth for inspiration on these. But other than that, I pretty much go through and come up with a lot of the general idea of what I'm going to do on the spot. So there's a lot of spots in the video where you'll see me kind of try something out and then delete it and try something else. I tried to edit most of that out, so it should be a pretty straightforward build. So right here I just eased the ground up to where there's a nice gentle slope on either side leading down to that interchange. So now we just need to upgrade everything. I made sure the bridge was kind of wide and made it connect directly into the interchange. And that leaves room if we ever need to lengthen the queues on the interchange, or if we decide to run other sorts of transit or roads underneath of that bridge. All we have to do is just move the dirt back. So, kind of future-proofed it. So now I'm just going to take the dirt here and just kind of hug it up next to these, so that way I can keep that same level ground going that I've been using for the residential areas already. Just kind of keep the city nice and level. I don't think I'm going to build too much on the hills with buildings and stuff like that. So just kind of straightening it up, making it look a little bit more uniform. And then every road, of course, that comes off of these will slope the road up to it. So the next thing I'm going to work on here is just extending this main road. So I'm just going to slope the ground up, make sure it's nice and gentle slope. It adds to the city, adds to the realism of it, I think. I think it makes it look a lot smoother, a bit more planned out, like it belongs there once it's built. So I'm just going to do that on both sides, and I'll do the same thing on the final angle on that other side for the frontage road to join into that. So there's the basis for that. Now we're going to start connecting our roads down here and making our property plot for where our shopping center is going to go. So I'm just going to keep this frontage road on a nice even pace with the interstate here. And then just kind of follow the pattern I've already been using with the other interchanges and just kind of bring it right up and around directly into this roundabout, and that'll be the end of that road. So I tried finding a good curve angle for this, but just wasn't feeling like I was going to get it even. So I decided to draw the road out straight like this on both sides, and then just kind of put this little bit of road in the middle, just curve to it. I think that made it turn out really decent. So right here is where I relocate the windmills. I live in Wyoming, and all over on top of hills in Wyoming, we have windmills like this. And although I don't recall seeing any down in the southern Colorado area like that, I still think it's a nice aesthetic to just have. You know, I mean, this doesn't have to be exactly the way that things are built down there. It's just an inspiration for the city. A reason why I chose Pueblo to kind of model this city after is on the PlayStation you only get 9 tiles to build with, and so I figured to give a nice decent look, build more of a smaller town like that, a smaller city like that, instead of trying to make something like Los Angeles or New York crammed into 9 tiles. Is just, it's very tough to do. So lining up all these roads, I didn't want them to be perfectly lined up. I like how it has the little curve going into the old neighborhood that we already built. This area is kind of going to be sort of for a green area, but later on I wind up putting some city services up there in that little bar. So we're going to add in our strip mall. And that's just to kind of give me a landmarker, you know, a place to start. That's the anchor that I'm going to build off of. I wind up putting a road behind it and flipping it around later on to where it faces the inside of this big shopping center. But I'm just going to build out our grid for this a little bit. And I'm going to break it up. You know, it's going to have some spots that are really squared off and other spots that kind of curve together and make it seem like a unique design that was thought out for this area. I can imagine these shopping centers, you know, maybe they're owned by the same person, or, you know, the companies made a deal together to get this whole plot here. So they wanted to build this huge shopping center, add in some residential for people to work. Right now, that's what I would consider a balanced need in city skylines. When your city's doing good, usually your city needs will look kind of like this, mostly residential, about halfway on commercial, and about a third of the industrial. That seems like a pretty standard need for a healthy city. But here, once I start building some of this commercial, you'll see my residential goes way up, and I wind up having to add even more residential than I had originally planned to put in this video. But it all works out. It's just kind of an area off to the other side of that arterial that I build. And it works. It just makes the city look that much better. So right here I'm adding some residential roads. Just kind of putting them in the space, as much space as can be filled with them. You know, yeah. And just having connectivity to this frontage road that's also kind of like a collector road. I upgraded it off camera to this 4-lane road, as you can see there. Just to improve on traffic. It was definitely a major road. So right here you can see where the grid's kind of broken up. What you can do to fix that is just take one of your other roads and upgrade it to that, and it'll fix that broken grid when you're making things like fences, or if you build another road next to it that impedes on the original grid that you had. You just find where it's broken, like right there where there's only three deep, and just upgrade it, and that'll fix that grid, and then you can change it back to the original road you had it planned on. And that's one reason why planning with dirt roads can also be really good too. So right here we're gonna make our first city district. I'll go through later on, maybe I'll do another episode later on where we go through and make a whole bunch of districts, you know, maybe make the old town that we made into like two more districts, and start playing with some of the policies. But my main reasoning behind this district here was I was gonna use something out of the Green Cities DLC for some of the housing, but then I just decided to go with the standard city skylines housing that, you know, just builds on its own. And we'll get into some of the more custom looking housing later, the different building styles and everything. So I was a little bit less picky about the lot sizes with this part of town because I think between residential and commercial, everybody would be trying to squeeze every inch of building and business that they could into these places just to be a part of this shopping center area. So I'm about to make another district here. And again, you'll need the Green Cities DLC for it. And use the organic commercial zone for it, because you need it to use or to make the parking lot asset that I'm going to show how to build in this. So it takes quite a process. You just basically wait for a certain kind of business. An electrical car charging station pops up, and it's a parking lot. And you just have to wait for the buildings to spawn and then be deleted, and just historicalize them as the right one pops up. So I'm going to start building these 2x4 lots here. Now, because we only have low density commercial, I have to spread them out like this. But if you have high density, you can fill in every other space with high density too, and you'll still get the same parking lot building that appears. There's also a 4x4 one as well. So I'm going to draw this road down behind the strip mall there. And then on the other side, I'm going to do these 4x4 lot sizes to get another smaller parking lot looking asset. But it just takes time. You just have to let the building spawn. So right off the bat, I have the one of the right ones pop in, the first building. And like I said, I'll kind of show the process of how this works. It just takes time. I build a little bit and then come back and delete and historicalize, and then build a little bit more. But after I show it once or twice, the process of what I'm doing, I edited the rest out because it just gets repetitive. It takes a long time to fill in, and it would have taken up way too much footage and time in the video to just show this whole process that's very repetitive, and I can just show with a couple of clips of how I'm putting it together and saving the buildings and such. It's not essential, you know, it's just it looks good. So I'm putting these fences around the two roads that lead into this, so that way I can maximize the grid on these side roads that I'm putting these residential buildings on. Going through and upgrading those roads and then fixing them again because the grids were broken. And you can also fix that by putting a fence around your road first before you put your interior roads in there. You know, this was all just kind of coming to me as I was building it. I had a basic idea of what I wanted and how it was going to be, but the actual road layout and everything was just kind of on the fly. And none of it's perfectly squared off. I didn't want it to be. I wanted it to kind of look more made to fit. You know, these businesses were going in. The city wanted them. And so they made the grid fit around them instead of trying to make them fit into the grid. Which, because right now I only have this kind of outer city area residential, there isn't much of a grid yet. The main roads have, you know, a rough grid layout, but everything's still pretty curvy and just kind of space filling. As we get more into the inner city, and especially doing the higher density stuff, I'm gonna have more of a straight grid for the town. So I'm just kind of letting everything fill in. This is just kind of that process of, you know, you go through and save the right ones and delete all the rest, and it takes a long time. But the end is definitely worth it. It turns out looking really well. When you're willing to take the time to do this. And I left that one square on the edge there of the lower parking lot there, and then the one square grid in the middle. I wind up putting park trees with paths in there. I think that part might have gotten edited out of the video, but you can see it in the end when I fly over the city. So just trying to pack as much residential in here as I can. You can see now my residential need is skyrocketing, and my commercial and industrial are way low. And I started having a death wave. I had to add a cemetery and then also a new garbage dump here in a minute as well. So I got my new milestone, got the highway roads that I needed. And then I turn the rest of this too that we've made going down the city into the actual highway roads instead of the slower one-way residential roads. And then also with all these interchanges, I put in the single lane ramp road, at least off the highway on these smaller interchanges. It still goes up into a two lane, so that way they have the right and left lane. But for this one, I bring it all the way up to the two-way road using the single lane, just to follow road mathematics. I think after I was done recording, I went through and made the highway stretches between the exits on all the interchanges down to two lane, just to match that roadway mathematic. You'll see it in the next video that I'm working on. So just adding more of those fences, trying to maximize the grid, and I don't want to accidentally zone in something on this road here that's supposed to be more of just a transport road, a road just to get into the area, but not really have anything to impede traffic. Just takes you straight in. There's no businesses on it, no houses on it. And it's just to feed that lower end of town right into it without having to get on either of the four-lane roads on either side of town. So yeah, you can see where I skipped ahead. I skipped a lot of that building and deleting process with the parking lot, and it's almost filled in now. Just adding more residential, trying to pick up that commercial needs, so that way the rest of that can fill in. Here in a minute, I actually start on another neighborhood across the other side of the arterial, just to make up for this massive residential need that I needed to fill this huge shopping complex center. So just kind of an overview of what we've done so far. This is the entirety of the city. It's been a good work in progress. So far we've really only built on the one side of the highway. As I've stated in the other two videos, that industrial area up there is mostly temporary. Maybe I'll make it look nicer just as the original industrial complex of town and kind of historicalize it, but we're going to get into our industries here in the next video. And a lot of that need for that general industrial like that is going to disappear as I build one of the major industries. So this is the start of the grid for the neighborhood that I needed to fill this massive residential need. There was nothing too complicated to it, just a single road leading off the collector road into it, you know, a single main road leading out. I deleted these roads here because I wanted to go back and kind of suck up that overflow of dirt, keep these roads nice and flat. And it winds up working out because I run a path underneath that that roundabout there that leads to the shopping center from this neighborhood, so it has some good connectivity to it. Bring water pipes over. So when I laid down the grid, I laid down an extra space to where the grid is absent in the exact middle space between the roads, so that way I can add paths. Not only is walkability a good thing, but a lot of neighborhoods between the houses have alleyways, and I kind of look to building in this space between the grid there. You can see me deleting it as like alleyways. You know, that's where people would park the truck they're not driving and keep their garbage cans, and you know, just seems like every neighborhood with good housing like that has alleyways. So add a little strip of commercial on that main road there, just so that way there's still a bit of a destination. It's not just isolated residential by itself, and you can see it filling in over there in the other side of the arterial, but it's filling in so fast that this neighborhood was much needed and completely filled in by the time I finished. So this is the parking lot. There's like one or two spaces left to fill in this parking lot over here on the left, but it's starting to look really, really good. I'm really happy for how it turned out. So I'm just adding some paths around the parking lot, just a little bit more walkability. Same with along the side of the strip mall here, just to get from the main road back to parking. I think this is, yeah, I flipped that strip mall around off camera there. So there's a couple more things to add, kind of waiting on the parking lot there. There's some more paths that I add, but and a couple of overviews that I do just to kind of show you, you know, this is pretty much the road layout. There above the strip mall in that big space right here, actually, I add some city services, clinic, police station, fire department. Just kind of give them their own road, especially off this sort of main area of town. Add in some paths. And then here pretty soon, we're going to just dive into a super sped up hour and a half detailing binge that I went on. This is where I build that path that goes under the roundabout here and connect this neighborhood in another way to the shopping center. Just go right underneath the roundabout. Took me a minute to get all the measurements right to do this, and it still wound up popping up out of the ground like that, so I upgraded it to the park road because it's self-leveling. Just makes it look smoother. Alright, so this is the general layout of what's been done in the build so far. Now all that's really left, there's a couple more things that I throw in here. But now all that's left is just diving into all the detailing. I'm going to replace all the trees and fill in a lot of this green space that we have, this empty area here, and give it some character. I think this is probably the largest green space area that I fill in. So, I guess we're going to dive into a really long detailing session that I was able to chop up into about 8 minutes. So, I'm going to speed it up, play some music, and get rolling. Alright guys, so that wraps up our video for today. I hope you really enjoyed the content. I hope you liked the change up in filming style. Let me know what you think of this stuff in the comments. Drop a like and subscribe, and thanks for tuning in.